next slide is some, I would say, feeds from the market. What's happening, okay? I mean, entry points in terms of the market movements. So there are some acquisitions, cooperation, and strategic partnership. I picked some examples. So Microsoft, to have like a sharp portfolio that enabled Microsoft to enter the telecom market, they did acquisitions. They acquired Affirmed, they acquired Metaswitch, and resulted from that, Microsoft now, they have a full 5G offering, like an IMS, they can offer everything, anything in a box. So they have this kind of way of approaching that. If you get Azure for operators, you get our full stack of core functions, of cloud native function. And that's what helped them in AT&T, because actually AT&T already had Affirmed and Metaswitch. So that's what made the deal more easy. On the other hand, for example, AWS doesn't seem to do the same. They don't acquire or get companies, but they tended to do a lot of partnerships, a lot of partnerships. And I just extracted some names, you know, latest announcement. NEC 5G Core is on AWS, Netcracker OSS BSS on AWS, Amdocs OSS orchestration on AWS, Ericsson BSS on AWS, Nokia, Mavenir, ORAN, and a lot of many other things on AWS. So that's one of the value propositions of AWS. And when you get AWS, you get this list of certified partners. So you can just go with a digital experience to drag and drop what kind of application that you want, or you can enjoy a SaaS model, software as a service model from these partners. So this is like some directions from the hyperscaler. From the other side, the operators, they go into strategic partnerships. We see that in the market. Lately, last year, maybe earlier this year, SEC announced an investment of $500 million in Alibaba Cloud. So that's one of the strategic partnerships. We also saw the AT&T announcement with Microsoft Azure. And the next slide is a case study of AT&T. And I guess a few days also British Telecom BT announced the same strategic partnership with Microsoft Azure. So Rakuten is a little bit different because Rakuten is not just a mobile operator. Okay, think of Rakuten as a cloud platform provider, same like AWS. So they build their Rakuten Mobile in Japan with a certain setup, and they will try to replicate this model to all operators. So they are going to sell this cloud platform, same like AWS is doing. They are going to build that to other operators. We see there's a lot of agreements and partnerships and MOUs that were signed. Rakuten with Etisalat, Rakuten with STC, Rakuten with some operators in Germany. So Rakuten is not just a mobile operator. No, they are also a cloud platform operator. They see themselves as one of the coming hyperscalers, and they are going to replicate this model to other operators.